Let's dive a little deeper. Got a little home time in the house with it. Let's dive a little deeper into this manifesting thing.
I'm living a new life in the sun and the moonlight. I'm trying to just do right, 'cause I'm living a new life. I'm living a new life.
So, I thought about the times of the society that we live in, and I thought about other people besides like-minded people. For instance, there are some women who are traumatized, who were, you know, abused by men, and they're not having it. They're just not gonna have it. I mean, that's just from my understanding. It's, you know, 'cause there's creepy ass men out here and they just destroy children. You know, there's creepy-ass women out here that destroy children. It's a lot of attackers. And so some women really like, you know, I'm going to make do without a man because it's just an ultimate no for me. Cool. You know, some people just have to understand that. And as far as for some men, I understand that, you know, some women have used and abused them for quite a while. And they are just in the energy of, I'm not doing anything for anyone else but myself from now on. You know, so when I look back on the video, I say, you know, it does kind of have a direction to it. Because ultimately, I believe that, you know, for the most part, what the scripture says is true. The structure of that makes the Most High happy. It's God, man, woman, and children. But in the effort to understand outside the bounds of what my beliefs, I said, let's break man down into an acronym for people to use, even for myself to use. What is it that people are successful people, financial freedom people, what are they doing? This is what I thought. Because, you know, thinking about all this stuff is like, okay, and I saw the video over. I was like, all right, it's kind of trying to push women towards men. And then there's some women who are just like, nah, I'm a staunch lesbian. I'm done with men. Then there's some men that are like, they didn't jump the fence, but they're just like, I'm just taking care of myself. Because I can understand from that point of view of just taking care of yourself and really not wanting to risk your peace and your sanity for someone that's going to play games and act like this and act like that. And after so much time, it's like, oh, I'm totally ungrateful for what you did. So look, I started looking at successful people. I said, what are they doing? But then it ultimately runs back to man. See, it manifests, yeah, man, I fest, but there's another holy trinity. It's the first three letters. the first three letters, M-A-N. And I was like, okay, but what are these successful people doing? What are they doing? So I look at Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, rest in peace, Steve Jobs. And I even analyzed MKBHD, you know, Marquise Brown Lee. I analyzed Unbox Therapy, Lou from Unbox Therapy. I started analyzing people, even Linus Tech Tips, Linus from Linus Tech Tips. I'm like, you know, what are these people have? What are all these successful people? Even the guy that I work for, he's successful, has plenty trucks, has a small fleet. What are all these people have in common? And my thought was, they know how to manage and navigate. Because dealing with the guy that I work for, he's gained my respect because he knows how to manage his business and navigate the trucking industry. Keeps us rolling, keeps us working, keeps us. And I'm like, okay. Then I analyzed Lou from Unbox Therapy. He started in the attic with a camera. Now, I want to say a camera phone. Editing on the phone, uploading. He has a successful business. Marquise Brown Lee. He started at his parents' house with a computer and a webcam. And I'm like, okay, so we know Bill Gates' story, Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk, Steve Jobs. We know these guys' story, but what do they all have in common? They know how to manage and navigate. Because I'm trying to help my life out, right? Trying to help my life. Trying to be somewhere successful, doing something, and running on a hamster wheel. Yes, we all learn how to manage ourselves. But it seems like a lot of us manage ourselves going nowhere. While the successful people, and there's many more successful, not just the name men, successful women, and many more people. And I'm pretty sure what they have in common, they know how to manage and navigate. Not to hark on the man thing, the M-A-N, but we're talking about manifesting a future for yourself that you want. I'm talking about manifesting a future for myself that I want. And then looking and self-reflecting, like I've just been managing myself with no aim. Like I know, okay, people have hobbies. I have a lot of hobbies. Not an exorbitant amount, but I have a lot of hobbies. I have a few, to say the least. And it's like, what successful people have in common, they know how to manage themselves, manage their time, manage their focus, manage their education, manage their responsibilities, their manage their finances and their financial obligations, as well as navigating to a vision, navigating to a goal that they want. And I believe, you know, bringing all things into culmination with, oh, vision board. You got to have vision and speaking things to existence. When you bring it all together, you still have to navigate that way. That's what I said in the last video. It's like planting a seed, reaping what you sow. That's the same thing. But, you know, we don't live in a society, a reality of farming. So it doesn't really hit like it's supposed to. So let's bring that same demeaning, reaping what you sow, into an actual modern day type of understanding. We have plenty of examples around us of people who know how to manage people also. They know how to manage people. Manage people that want to be a part of the ship. You know? You know, there's a term. Got to get on board. You want to get on board? You got to get on board. You want to be down with this ride? You got to get on board. Get on board. Okay, you're getting on board. Now, the captain of the ship has to know how to manage the ship and navigate the ship. Even though successful ships have their own... This is why it's important to have a navigation system to know where you're going before you get there. Know how to get to your destination before you get there. We all use a GPS. That's a navigator. We type in our destination, and then there's a road we have to take. There's a route we have to take to get from where we are to the destination we want to be. And we have to manage safely traversing through traffic, going through the city. All of that plays in the part to you getting to the destination. So in your life, from what I'm understanding, pardon me, I'm over here cooking. From what I'm understanding is successful people have a vision and they do the research and have some guides, people to talk to, mentors, to help them get to where they're trying to get to. It's always nice to have someone already at the destination you're trying to get to already there, so they can tell you how to get there. But we all don't have that luxury. Some people don't like talking to people. Like I said earlier, you know, some women just don't like men at all. So if you're trying to get to a destination and there's no women there, then it's like, how are you going to navigate there? You know, that's a personal problem. And like, say a man that wants to be a nightclub owner, but you don't trust women at all, like, how are you going to get there? You know, that's just something. But I thought about it. Managing and navigation. You have to manage and navigate. That's how you man up. For a woman, she can man up. Yeah, it's man's in woman. It's there. Man is a part of woman. Woman, it's there. So a woman can man up. Just manage and navigate yourself to the destination you want to be. If you have a body count goal, manage and navigate yourself to your body count goal. And I only keep bringing that up because that is wild, ridiculous. That is some devious succubus demon shit. Like, what is your point of existing on Earth? That don't even make sense. Yeah, and the same thing for men. Like, you have a body count goal. your destination is frivolous. You're trying to go to a place that doesn't have an address, in my opinion. Anyway. So for a man who wants to man up in his life and level up in his life, manage your time, your money, manage your focus, your energy, manage your life so you can, no, you have to manage all that and figure out how to navigate there. This is just, see, it's just like a, it's like an epiphany. It's like an epiphany I'm sharing. Last video, this video, it's like an epiphany. Like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I've been managing myself to nowhere, to go nowhere. Bunch of hobbies, got a job. I got a job to pay bills. As long as I got a roof over my head, food in the refrigerator, I should be good. You know, that's what single mothers teach the children. That's what children witness from single mothers. Just work, have a food, water, and shelter. That's all that's important. But it's like, after a while, you understand and know food, water, and shelter is something that's always going to be here. You're always going to do that for yourself. Be it if you live with someone else, you're always going to have some type of food, water, and shelter, unless you're deliberately being homeless. Being homeless takes effort. Being a bum on the street takes a hell of a lot of effort. It takes a lot to be living on the street and alive. It takes organizational skills. It takes, you got to know what you want to do every day, what you going to get and how you going to get it, and just being a drug addict and homeless, that shit takes a lot of effort. Like, this, it's, I think the problem with a lot of that is managing with no goal. Managing your life or yourself with no GPS, no going nowhere. That's why a lot of times I think people end up nowhere. Because I've been homeless a few times. And it's like, it was a conscious decision. Like, fuck paying this rent, fuck all that. I can work and keep my money and this, that. It takes a lot of effort. But that comes from managing yourselves with no goal. No aspiration, going nowhere, manage yourself. So now, thinking about this type of way, thinking in this type of way, it's like, okay, that's what the successful people are doing. They're putting a goal out there for themselves, and I'm pretty sure we've heard this before. Putting a goal out there for themselves and going to achieve it. Ain't that what they say? They say what? Set easily obtainable goals. So when you get that, you keep going for the next. It's easier, or you have more motivation to go for the next and bigger goal. You set the small goals that are easily obtainable, achievable. So when you achieve it, you get the gratification of my hard work paid off. Hard work paid off. My hard work paid off. And I got to this point. Now, what's the next destination? So you start developing a skill of managing yourself, and navigating towards that first little short goal. And I believe after a while, you would get used to setting goals for yourself and going to achieve those goals. But I think it's hard and disingenuous to not have ever, I don't want to say ever, but to start out with an high, exorbitant, out of this world spacecraft goal, and you don't even know how to navigate. I think the navigation is the part a lot of people are missing. So manage and navigate. Man up. Woman, man up. Man, men, man up. That's if you want to. You know, a lot of people don't want to achieve an astronomical goal. Maybe, you know, a lot of people have lived, everybody lived their own life, their own kind of way. And, you know, you never know. For some people, they might have achieve their life goal already, and their life goal could be very simple, and it's not up to you to judge the next person because they're satisfied at where they're at. They've achieved what they wanted to achieve and really don't have a desire to achieve something greater in your eyes. Because their achievement is the greatest achievement in their eyes. Does that make sense? Manage and navigate. This is like, I just turned 40, but I'm going into 41. And it's like my life in hindsight, I said, well, damn, what isn't always a constant? Food, water, and shelter is always a constant. You make your money, you make your money. The first thing you want to do, even a vehicle is a shelter. A vehicle is a roof over your head. People that are homeless, someone who's homeless in their car versus homeless on the street without one, that's two different levels. That person who has the car has the shelter. Every day they're going to make sure the best of their ability to ingest some type of food, drink some liquid. That is the basic necessity, and that is, it's always a constant. You know, and I said, you know, that's a single mother's type of deal, achievement, food, water, and shelter. My kids have a place to live. They're not on the street. They're not homeless. My kids are in the house, food, water, and shelter. I must obtain and keep this and maintain this and keep this, which is nothing wrong with that. Outside of that, for people who want to manifest their successes, that's the first achievement, that's your first level, that's your first goal, then, you know, especially if you come from nothing, a lot of people who come from nothing, they know how to, they really did learn how to navigate to a achievement. They really did learn how to navigate to a goal. Fortunately or unfortunately, whatever, my mom's always kept a roof over our head. We had food, water, and shelter, and extra shit. Video games, TVs, computers, and extra shit. So, stepping out into the world is kind of different. because having everything provided for you that you didn't even know was very hard to obtain. It was just always given. So it was like, man, what's wrong? Why? What's wrong with my life? Why is this? Why is that? Whoa, nigga, because you only know how to manage. Get to navigating. So women, you know, accept my apology. The staunch hardcore lesbians who view men and want to throw up. Take that as a mode of encouragement for yourself. You as a woman, man up, learn how to manage and navigate to your goal. And hopefully your goal is not a body count goal. And men from all different walks of life and different upbringings, you know, just coming to America and being here in America, that is a high goal that a lot of people don't get to achieve. So you've navigated your way here. And for, you know, the men that are already here, you know, and you have food, water, and shelter for yourself. Be it even if you're homeless, living in your car, or you have a place of your own, and you have a drive to better yourself, whatever your situation is, manage. You've been already managing. Keep learning to manage, but navigate yourself. Plant the seed for the direction for your feet to go. Plant the seed and reap what you sow. You know, they always give that term a bad connotation. Like, oh, you're going to reap what you sow, you old dirty bastard. Which is true. But you can also reap what you sow in the direction of success. Plant the seed. People who want to be computer coders, you have to learn coding step by step by step by step by step. People who've learned coding 20 years ago, who still coding 20 years later, they are at a higher degree of coding. You know, basketball players, football players, you know, everything. You can look to everything, even technology in itself. It was infantile in the 90s, even more infantile and rudimentary in the 80s and 70s. But now technology is like, it has maturated to a point, and that's how you can look at your navigation as you manage yourself to keep bettering yourself to get to that goal. To be somebody you've never thought you can be, or somebody you believe you can be. Or even in a place, a status, a situation where you believe, but you just can't sit back. You know, the scripture says, faith without works is dead. You can manage yourself and have faith that you're going to be, or you deserve something better. But you don't work it towards that way, you'll never achieve it. That's something I've learned. I'm sharing something I've learned. As I said with the last video, I'm sharing something I've learned. I'm sharing a lesson. It's like a life lesson. You wasted 40 years on what? Just managing your time, managing your efforts, your energy, and you've been managing this shit. Stupid. Lack of a better term. In my opinion, for myself. And I said, well, what, you know, I got a job, I got food, water, and shelter. What are you talking about? Well, look at the successful people. Don't you think they got food, water, and shelter? What else do they got besides food, water, and shelter? Oh. And I didn't think, how do they get it? You talking about manifest, man, I fest, man, I confess, profess, nigga. Man up, nigga, man up. Nigga, oh shit, manage and navigate. Manage and navigate. Manage and navigate. Plant the seed for your future. And remember, there's a remedy for the nightmares and the scariness of the unknown. There's a remedy. Face your fears. Face the things that are scary about not knowing what the future holds. Just because you've never been to that level, you don't know about that level. And the stories you hear, you already know how they do with stories. Oogie boogie, nigga, don't go over there. Don't go over there. Don't do that. Oogie boogie, nigga. And what happens? A lot of times, damn, you was just keeping me out of the loop of the good shit. Telling me, you know, the haters. You gotta manage who you keep around you. Haters. People who don't want to see you succeed, don't want to see you do better, because they might feel that you're already better than them. They don't want you to do no better. Oogie boogie. Don't go over there. Don't fuck with her. Don't fuck with him. They gonna do you like this. They gonna do you like that. You ain't hear the stories? Meanwhile, that's a person that's pivotal on your travel. That's a person that's pivotal on your navigation. I'm gonna make this last point. How many of y'all play RPG games? Zelda, Pokemon, Elder Scrolls, all these RPG role-playing games. You got to talk to the NPCs to get to the mission, through the mission. God of War, you got to talk to the NPCs, and the NPCs want to tell you how to get to the next destination, how to get to the place that you're getting to. I'm going to send you to the next person. You talk to me, all right, I'm going to tell you X, Y, and Z, but then you got to go talk to the next person. You can't be so biased. You can't be so afraid all the time. Sometimes you're blocking your own blessing, right? You're blocking your own GPS. You're blocking your own route. You put in a roadblock in your own route. And all praises to the Most High, the Ineffable One. Let him keep on working on everything. Because he know the truth. And he knows your heart. And he knows what people who are following his steps. Faith without works is dead. I don't care who you are, what you say, but none of that. You can't sit on your ass, have all these expectations, and do nothing. That's dead. Dead going to ground. Dead going to trash into the dump. Dead going to pot fried up. Goes nowhere. Dead turns into shit. Being a piece of meat with a body count goal, you're a piece of shit. Because what happened to meat? Put it in the pot, chew that thing up, hits the belly, go straight in the toilet. You being the tool, that's what, you know, you're a tool. What happened to a tool? Rusty toolbox. Done with it. Anyway.
living a new life in the sun of the moonlight. I'm trying to just do right.